Welcome to the Rusted Garden Homestead. This is part two of two on overwintering your pepper plants. So today we're going to take the peppers out of the ground or containers, put them in new containers, and we'll go over all these materials in a second. So here's the key. If you're moving your peppers inside from outside, of course, in the ground, or into a greenhouse, you do not want to move earth from your garden into the house or into the greenhouse because you will bring in insects that you don't want there. So we're going to dig out the pepper plants. In the first video, I showed you how to prune them and get them ready, you know, up top. So now we're going to basically dig these out, knock the dirt off the roots, and then we're going to pot them back up. So there's a couple of things you can do to limit the amount of insects coming into your greenhouse or into your house, because you want these to overwinter at least 45 degrees or warmer, not much past that, 55 degrees or so. If they get too warm, then you basically can just grow your peppers inside. We're overwintering them, so we're kind of taking them as they're hibernating. We're going to keep them, you know, alive until the spring comes, put them outside. So the materials you need, of course, are some containers. I'm just using containers that I save as I bring in plants. You're going to want materials to make a potting mix. Now, you can just buy straight potting mix from your big box stores. It doesn't matter which one you buy. That will have less insect potential in there than your garden soil, but it could have fungus gnats. I'm going to show you a trick with sand in a second to limit that issue too. So if you don't want to mix up stuff like I'm going to do now, just buy a potting mix and then you repot your pepper with the potting mix. So this is what the pepper plants will look like when we're done. A couple things that might be confusing. So temperatures 45 degrees Fahrenheit or so, 50 degrees, if they're going to be in a cellar, garage, maybe in a greenhouse that's not the best, that's unheated. You don't really want it to get much colder, so stick around 45 degrees. In the cellar or in a garage, they're going to need some direct sun, so about 6 hours of grow lights would be good, but you can keep those grow lights a foot above them. You're just giving them enough light to know that light's around. In the house, of course, it's going to be about 70 degrees. By a window that gets a combination of 6 to 8 hours of indirect direct sun is fine. So they may sprout leaves, they may grow a little bit indoors, but we're just going to keep the watering down. We're not feeding them, we just want them to survive. In a greenhouse that's a better greenhouse, these may take off depending on what the temperatures are, what the lows get in there. They're going to be getting tons of sun from outside, but because it's winter, they're not going to be getting as much sun as normal, so they may still kind of stay dormant. So it's all going to really depend on where you put them, what the plants might do. Before you bring them inside, any organic insecticide is great, and just soak the stems down both sides. I would spray the top of the soil. You know, I'll have to get the other side of these plants, but you get the idea. The insecticide, and these are ready to go inside. And I was going to put them in the cellar, but I'm actually going to take them upstairs to my grow room because I want to watch them and see what they do over the next 4 or 5 months. You can get a bag of topsoil. This is pretty much sand and some other stuff. Not a whole lot living in there. It's inexpensive. And a bale of peat moss or cocoa core, and you do 50% peat moss, 50% of this basic topsoil. You're not going to get a lot of life in there. It'll be just the right medium to take care of your roots for your overwintering pepper. You'll limit the amount of insects coming in. And again, it would be 50% topsoil, 50% peat moss or cocoa core, or you could go and get some garden soil. Garden soil is just an upgrade from here with more wood product and peat moss in there. So you could buy this, so it would be a bag of that and about 25% peat moss, and you get the idea. You're just making a basic potting mix, really. You can do it from scratch or you can buy the potting mix. Now, here's the key. You also want something like grocery bag paper. And I'll show you how to do it, but I'm going to explain it to you first. So when you bring your potted plant inside, if you're growing peppers in pots and you just brought the pot inside, all the bed insects in there are going to go crazy in your house or in the greenhouse and just take over. So what you can do is a trick. We can plug the holes. So you put some of the brown paper down there, cover the holes, put about a half an inch of sand, put in your potting mix, whatever you're using, and then another half an inch or to an inch of sand. That sand on top will stop fungus gnats from being able to travel up and down through the soil, also stops other insects, and then the paper and sand on the bottom will stop insects from getting out into the house. That's just a good way to really protect your home and your greenhouse from the insects. All right, so let me set up some of this. I'm going to just start with 50% topsoil, peat moss, and then we'll get these pots ready, and then I'll show you, basically gonna dig the plants out, bang off the soil, and then pot them up. So here's what my potting mix is gonna look like. It's just 50% topsoil and peat moss. It's a nice mix. So we put in some of the brown paper or grocery bag right in the bottom. You're gonna put in about a half an inch of sand, and that's just really to secure the bottom so the insects don't come out. So that's all you really have to do. Again, our plants are dormant. We're not trying to grow them inside leaves and fruit. We just want them to survive. Now that means once this is filled, the plants in there, we're gonna water it once outside, let it drain out. And then maybe once a month, you give it a little bit of water just to keep it moist. You don't need to feed them. You're not trying to grow them. You just want them to survive. So let me get the plants ready. We'll pot up a couple and then we'll talk about what you do to take care of them while they're dormant over the next couple of months. So that's my ghost pepper. Make sure you label all your plants too. They're all gonna look the same. And we're just gonna dig out, try and go 6 inches, 8 inches away from the stem here. Be a little bit more difficult because the raised bed is there, but you're just cutting into the soil. And then once you cut in and you square it out, nice and deep, and lift out the roots. And you just want to break it up. Don't pull up the whole plant because it could the roots could break off the stem. Loosen it up and then just slowly work the pepper plant up, trying to keep a lot of the roots intact. And this is exactly what you want. Nice root system. The top has been trimmed up. I will link this video in the video description of this one so you can see the first part, but that looks great. Now, sand's already in there. You're just going to coil the roots in. This pot could be just a little bit bigger, but you want it to fit in something like that. And then you're going to kind of lift this and just let your new potting mix surround the roots, tuck in whatever roots are popping out. This could come off. And you're just making a nice home for your plant to stay dormant and survive over the next 4 or 5 months. Again, we will water this in. I'll talk more about how you take care of them in the house. So press it in, and then this is where you add about the half an inch of sand to really stop any fungus gnats that might be in your potting mix or any problematic insects from being able to easily get out. The sand is so fine that small insects have a trouble going through this. Pack it down. And you get the idea. And this is what I'm gonna do for most of my pepper plants. Let me get them set up and we'll finish the video. So I've got about 6 peppers ready to go into my cellar actually. Red Ghost, Scorpion, Jalapeno, Anaheim Chili, Habanero Red, and Scotch Bonnet. So again, we're not gonna feed these. They're dormant, we want them to stay dormant. Just water them in enough to dampen the soil, keep the root systems damp. You know, maybe once or twice a month, not a lot of water. So some of these will be going into my cellar. My cellar stays at about 45 degrees Fahrenheit. That's probably the lowest I'd recommend. They will also go under basic grow lights, but the grow lights are gonna sit a good 12 inches above them. They're gonna be on about 6 hours. And it's kind of just giving them some indirect sunlight. It'll keep them dormant. If you're bringing them into your house, put them by a window where they'll get, you know, a good 4 or 6 hours of indirect light. They do need light. If they're going into your greenhouse, of course, if it's warm, there's a good chance they're going to start growing. Again, that's really up to you where you put them. But the whole key here is that we're not trying to grow these indoors. We're just trying to keep them alive, let them sit through dormancy. And then come spring, when it starts warming up, you can start feeding them, watering them more, get them outside, get them in the sun, bring them back in the house if the frost and freeze is coming at night, and you'll have your plants overwintered, and hopefully your peppers will do really well. Now, even if you follow everything perfectly, some of the peppers don't make it. That's just the way it is. Anyway, I hope this video and the other video gives you some confidence to try and overwinter your peppers. Please check out my seed shop at therustedgarden.com, and please subscribe. I'll be doing a brand new year, really, for 2021, from seed starting all the way through harvesting, and you can watch all my videos as I grow and take care of my plants through the 2021 season. Thanks for watching.